It has been over 6 months since our last Red Dead Online update, and in that time, there's actually been quite a bit of news that's been hinting towards the next update. Not so much when it's going to be dropped, but the things it might involve. This comes from different leaks from different people as part of the community that are actively searching what could be part of that update. But there's also been interviews from Rockstar employees where they actually go in depth and talk about the future of this game. So in this video, I'm going to be going through everything that's happened over the last 6 to 7 months, everything that's been hinting towards that next update. It might go without saying, but none of this is 100% guaranteed. We can start piecing little things together which might give us a rough idea, but it is not 100% confirmed. Before getting into the video, if you would like to see any more content from me, I am streaming over on Twitch every Monday, Wednesday and Friday. I stream a bit of RDR2 story and a bit of online, and I switch between the two. So if that does interest you, there is a link in the description down below. Head over to there, drop a follow, and you'll be notified the next time I go live. Getting back into the video, the first thing to talk about is the roles. And I think we are all very, very confident that we will see at least one role added to the game with the next update, hopefully even more than just the one. So far, what players are speculating is two, and the reason for that is because of an interview that happened in September 2019. This is a VG247 interview, and it talks about the new roles that just came out, the trader, collector, and bounty hunter. But it also talks about the future, how they will eventually add properties, but at that current point, it wasn't the right time. How roles will be expanded on, how they're listening to the community, and they're changing up customization, and the specific areas that future roles will fit in, being exploration, capitalism, wildlife, and nature. And that is an interview back in September, and in normal circumstances, because it's been so long since that interview, we would have thought the plans would have changed. But fast forward to December, we get the Moonshine role. That is when we get our first property, and then in January, Rockstar actually released this newswire. And this newswire is to celebrate the record-breaking year of 2019, because over the seasonal holiday, GTA had peak amounts of players, and so did Red Dead Online with the introduction of the Moonshine update. At the bottom here, there is a coming soon section, and it talks about what's going to be happening in 2020. For Red Dead Online, it says, as we have hinted at in the past, the world of Red Dead Online will also continue to grow in 2020 as we expand the concept of frontier pursuits with additional roles, new missions, and many more significant updates to come. And as you may notice, the point of where it says hinted at is underlined, and by clicking that, it will take you to the VG247 interview. The VG247 interview does contain a lot, but when you're reading through it, because it was back in September and because we have had a Moonshine update since then, we can start to see that the things that they mentioned in that interview have been ticked off. The only things that haven't been ticked off is where they mentioned high-ranked bounty hunters eventually being lawmen, the photography role, and also heists. It does say at the bottom at this VG247 interview that heist is one of those things that they will eventually add. It's definitely going to happen, but it has to be the right time. And that just made a lot of players think that maybe heists won't be part of this next update, with it being more likely that high-ranked bounty hunters will become lawmen, and also the introduction of a photography role. So that's got players speculating that we will have two roles with the next update. This could be completely wrong. They might actually add heists, and lawman and photography might be something that they add a lot later. But for Rockstar to hint towards this interview, and for everything within this interview to pretty much be done, we've already got properties in the game because properties have been added with the Moonshine update, and we will have more properties in the future, and they do go on to say that in other interviews. But to be linking back to this interview and all of that to be ticked off, it does get so many players believing that it's lawman, photography, or even heists, with more players thinking that it will be a lawman or photography role. The next thing is to talk about the Outlaw Pass. The Outlaw Pass will be happening. This seems to be a thing that Rockstar will be dropping every single update, because this is a way for them to reward players as well as just monetize the game, as it requires gold bars to buy into. So far, we've had two Outlaw Passes, one for the Frontier Pursuits update and one for the Moonshine update. The one that we had for the Frontier Pursuits update cost 35 gold bars, and it allowed you to rank up to a max rank of 70, unlocking rewards for every single rank. For the Moonshine update, with that Outlaw Pass, it actually increased. It went up to the price of 40 gold bars, but it also had a higher maximum rank, and the rank was rank 100. And yet again, you unlocked rewards for every single rank, so there was even more rewards with this one. With the way things are going and the amount of money and gold players have within this game, it is extremely likely that the next Outlaw Pass will be increased in price again to buy into, with there also potentially being a few more rewards here and there. Whatever the price they increase it to, it will still be worth it, especially if it has similar rewards to the first two Outlaw Passes. Because even though the first Outlaw Pass required 35 gold bars, you did also get that as a reward as you were progressing through it. For the second one, even though that required you to put 40 gold bars in and it was increased from the previous one, you still got 40 gold bars out of it. So if they increase it to 45, maybe even 50 gold bars, hopefully you still get those gold bars out, and you still get all the other items of clothing, ammo bundles, different types of herb packages, any type of customization for your horse or even weapons, it is definitely worth it. The next thing to talk about is the collector roll nerf that will most likely be happening. With the online interactable collector map, players are making thousands upon thousands upon thousands. It has actually made players rich. I think Rockstar expected players to go into the collector role, and they would stumble across random collectibles in free roam, which will make them a little bit more money. But for most of the time, you would have to go to Madame Nazar, buy a collector map, use that collector map to find those collectibles, get those collectibles, and then come back to Madame Nazar to buy another collector map. And you have that sort of back and forth with Madame Nazar, as well as just trying to find these collectibles. But that is not the case. Most players will just use the online interactable map, they'll find the collectibles without actually having to buy a collector map. And that has saved them a lot of money, and that has made them rich. So we all expected a collector nerf. With the Moonshine update, Rockstar even tried changing the collectible locations. They had new locations, as well as they changed up the cycles in which they would spawn into these locations. So it added a much bigger variation, but that still did not work. Still, the collector map was updated, and it did contain all of the new locations as well as the different cycles, and it tracked it very, very easily. In a Rockstar and Polygon interview back in February, Rockstar did even say that they would love to keep adding new collections and additional variety to the collector gameplay. This would mean that the online interactable collector map would then need to be updated, and there would be so many more different collectibles that you would have to manage. And much in a way that Rockstar added new cycles in which these collectibles would spawn in, they will probably do the exact same thing again, but with this time with even more collectibles to find. There has also been speculation within the community that Rockstar would cap how many collector sets that you can sell within a certain time. A lot of us right now have prepared for that next update. We've had a long time to do so. So we've all managed to collect 10 of every single set, because as soon as that next update drops, we'll go into the Outlaw Pass, we'll sign up for it, and then we can head over to Madame Nazar, sell all 140 collector sets, get 1500 XP for each set that we sell, and that would hopefully be enough XP to get from rank 0 to the maximum rank within the Outlaw Pass within just a matter of minutes. So even though there's a large amount of people that are doing that, including myself, we're all very skeptical about it, because we do think a collector nerf is on the way. And it's a nerf that Rockstar have hinted at with a previous update and also interviews that they've done. Whilst we're on the subject of the collector, we should also talk about the collector role additions. And yes, Rockstar have said within the two interviews that we've already mentioned that they will expand on the previous roles, but it seems like the collector role has a bit more attention to it, because they have even talked about the type of gameplay that they want. Yet again, going back to the Polygon interview, they did talk about new types of collection, which would be new content to the game. We do not know exactly what these new types of collection could be, but it could be pretty much anything. But they also talk about a different type of gameplay, where you're able to get collections as a posse. And that doesn't mean that you could just be part of a posse and you can all just carry on going through the collection set as normal, but each of you have to pick it up. This is completely different. This is about trying to focus on one collectible that is split up into multiple parts, and each posse member has to go to a different area of the map where they have to find a specific part of that collectible. And once everyone's successfully done their jobs, each posse member will come back together and they will put the collectible together for them to log it in their journal. And this is the first time that Rockstar have talked about what they mean by expanded on previous roles. A lot of us did think that they were just going to go and add another 20 ranks, taking it from the max rank for any type of role of 20 going all the way up to 40, with being able to unlock different stuff within each rank just like we was able to do within the first 20 ranks. But it seems like Rockstar do want to just carry on adding gameplay to it. And if this is the gameplay that we're going to be getting for the collector role, we can also see completely new gameplay mechanics with the bounty hunter, the moonshiner, and also the trader. They even talk about in this interview how they want to add this gameplay before they add the next variation, very similar to the moonshiner being a tier 2 to the trader. So it sounds like this new collector gameplay and the new collector set is a priority before anything else is added. Hopefully this would also be the case for the other roles as well, and hopefully we get some very nice gameplay, and hopefully this will be the same for the other roles as well within the next update, with them being expanded on with new types of gameplay, maybe even some new types of missions. The next thing is to talk about the properties that have been mentioned. In the VG247 interview back in September, they said at that current point it wasn't the right time to add properties. They wanted players to feel the progression of as soon as they start the game, they have to start their camp. They carry on working up, they go through the different roles, and then eventually they can buy their first property. We now know that the first property that they was on about was the Moonshine Shack. And with the introduction of that Moonshine Shack, we now know that Rockstar are happy with the progression and are starting to add properties to the game. Since that update, they have done a couple interviews, but I'm going to be referencing the Polygon interview again because they go in depth about the type of properties that will be coming. It says property owners have more to look forward to as well. Some of the new roles would let us introduce more feature-rich businesses and even communal spaces that properties can gather and meet up socially, lone wolves and full posses. Maybe even let each player own part of such a space. So in here we see the three different categories: feature-rich businesses, communal spaces, as well as part-owned spaces. Feature-rich businesses will probably be more along the lines of what we have with the Moonshine Shack. A communal space could very well be similar to what they have over on GTA Online when they introduced the casino. You don't actually have to buy anything to go into it, you can just go straight into the casino, and you can have fun with the bottom floor. But if you want a part-owned space, you can actually own parts of the casino. This is where you get to buy into the penthouse. And we can actually talk about this in a bit, going into what these spaces could actually be. But the last thing to talk about is the references in code to legendary animals, dynamic events, as well as the other things in Red Dead Online. The credit goes to Two Smoking Barrels, but I'm also going to leave Hazard and also Tez Fund's two links in the description down below because I will mention them. Two Smoking Barrels did find this code within the game. This gives an insight into MP007, which is referenced to the next update. MP006 was the Moonshine update, and MP005 was the Frontier Pursuits update, and it goes on like that. This code has reference to the different types of legendary animals coming to the game, as well as the dynamic events, as well as there's a second picture which has reference to some things that are already part of the game, but there's also some things that we have not seen within online. Hazard got linked this by Two Smoking Barrels, and he even put out on Twitter and asked if this was legit, with Tez Funds 2 actually replying saying yes, this is legit. So this has got many players excited for the next update, because in this code what you're seeing on screen is reference to quite a few things that players have been asking for quite some time. You have things in here like the Roanoke Trapper, which players have been begging for. You even have things like security door knock scenario and security door peek scenario, which could be something where we can rob stores. You can also find in here a shooting range, and this goes back to what I was saying earlier about properties. A shooting range could be one of those things that is a communal space where players can go over and test weapons, or it could be one of those things where it is a part owned own space. It has also been pointed out that with the shooting range, it could also be one of those things which Rockstar use for testing. One of those things where they're able to spawn it in to test weapons quickly rather than going in and out of the game. So this is the point where I throw it over to you guys. Out of all the stuff that's happened over the last 6 months with interviews, with a bit of speculation, with leaks, what do you think is real and what don't you? I also want to end the video asking you guys a question about this footage. This footage came from my Twitch channel. I was just streaming it. I went into a moonshine delivery with a full posse and I got an infinite loading screen. With infinite loading screens, when they happen, your wagon still spawns in, and if you're a part of a posse, it means your posse can actually still get the wagon and still do the mission whilst you're part of the loading screen. And you will still get money even though you're not actually able to do anything. You're just looking at a black screen. But whilst I was part of this black screen, my game glitched out and it spawned me back into my moonshine shack. My underground bar was completely black, but I also noticed that two new doors appeared in areas which there isn't doors. I was even able to go through these doors, but it just went into the abyss. There's nothing actually there. It seems like there's boundaries to two separate rooms, but there is nothing else spawning within them. It's just under the world of Red Dead Online. Whilst this was happening, chat was going absolutely crazy. I asked them, what do they think this is? Do you think that this could be potential content for the future? Two new expansions for the underground bar? And I ended up just saying that it's Marcel's sex dungeon. So I'm curious about what you guys think. Do you think that this is just a glitch that just happened and it spawned rooms in the underground bar and those rooms actually came from somewhere else? Or do you think this is a background update for what could potentially be a bar expansion? Let me know all your thoughts in the comment section down below. And if you do want to see me playing Red Dead Online live and potentially seeing live what just happened in that clip, then there is a link in the description down below which will take you to my Twitch channel. Head over to there, drop a follow, and you'll be notified when I next go live. But anyway guys, I hope you guys did enjoy. If you did enjoy, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe. But for now, I'm going. So see ya.